beginning the mailbag Monday, as I always do, with opening a beer. This is Mr. Canoehead from Sleeping Giant Brewing Company in Thunder Bay, Ontario. The malt and citra hops of this aromatic red ale will strike you like a lightning bolt, without fusing the canoe to your head. That's quite hoppy, more than I was expecting, but the malt taste is really nice. So the first item in is Diode and Diode. It is a bag of red LEDs. I guess that qualifies as Diode and Diode. They are just your basic, fairly bright red LEDs. Okay, I'm guessing that that was either a really good deal or replacing stock or a bit of both. 3/5mm LED lights, emitting diodes, lamps, beads, assorted round head, 5 colors, 100 pieces. Yeah, that pretty much sums it up. I got 5mm, 100 pieces of red. This is from 4U Discount 724. Another one of those excellent names. Currently, they are selling them for $2.96. I bought them $2.47 back in April. However, if you're in Canada, I would not suggest buying from this link. Just use the search term and you'll find lots of different sellers selling red LEDs. Next thing in is modules times one. Well packaged. Very well packaged. Oh, that's... Oh! That's more than one modules. That is a whole stack of modules. Yeah, I decided a few months ago to do something for absolutely beginners in Arduino. I went and picked out one of those, 45-in-1 sensor kits just to run through for beginners. Wow, there's like everything in this kit. Just to run through for beginners. I know coming up on Christmas time, there's always lots of questions on Reddit about what starter kit should I get, what module should I get, what module should I not get, stuff like that. So I'm planning on going through this thing in that. But just quickly, just see what we got that I can quickly see. There's a raindrop sensor. There's a capacitive soil, a resistive soil moisture sensor. That looks like a real-time clock. There's a breadboard power supply. Ultrasound. This looks like a, I don't know what that one is. That is an SD card and not the micro one either. That, I don't know what that one is either. In out, maybe a NeoPixel, maybe. And then there's all these guys. I see a joystick. I see a DHT11 in there. See some LEDs. I see a reed switch. I don't even know what half of these ones are, just quickly looking at them from here. Looks like there's a microphone kit, a microphone thing there. This is a rotary encoder, buzzers, and a bunch of things with LEDs on them. Yeah, anyways, I will go through that probably in November-ish, I'm thinking. Maybe late October, something like that. Anyways, that's what that is.
45-in-1 sensor module board kit upgrade version for Arduino 37-in-1 sensor BBC. I got this from Best Buy underscore CA, which, despite the name, is not, in fact, in Canada. They are in China somewhere, in Shenzhen. I did, in fact, pay $21.11 Canadian back when I bought it in May. I paid $2.38 shipping. This isn't actually out of this world for shipping. That's not, they're not gouging. I appreciate that. So they say this is an upgrade on the basic 37-in-1 kits. And yeah, well, it's got
It's got, eight more pieces in it. Sure. It's got a soil moisture sensor, infrared sensor, laser head sensor, temperature and humidity. That'll be the DHT11. Infrared emission sensor, a 5-volt relay, a gyro module, a finger detect heartbeat module, a microphone sensitivity sensor module, metal touch sensor module, flame sensor module, 3-color LED module, a hunt sensor module, I have no idea what that is, a magnetic Hall effect sensor, rotary encoder, active buzzer, magic light cup modules, again, no idea, passive buzzer, yeah, digital temperature sensor, a tilt switch, analogy holzer magnetic sensor, what? An ultrasonic module, mercury opening module, that'll be a tilt switch, a Hall magnetic sensor, there was another one up there. Maybe one's an analog and one's a digital. An RGB LED surface mount. A mini read switch module. A bicolor LED. Smart car avoid obstacle sensor. A key switch, photoresistor, breadboard power module. Hit sensor module. A temperature sensor. A third kind of temperature. A vibe sensor. Microphone sound sensor. Another different type of microphone sensor. A large read switch module. 2-color LED module. Optical braking module. Another temperature sensor module. A buck module. An MP1584 buck module. SD card reader. We saw that. PS2 joystick. We saw that. Flashing LED module. DS1302 real-time clock and a water level module.
That was a lot of reading. Okay, what is next? We have charger. Okay. I wonder what charger is. It's tiny. It is a package of drill bits. Perfect. So this is a package of 1/8-inch drill bits, aka 3.2 millimeter. I think that's 1/8-inch, isn't it? Yes, it is. And they are double-ended drill bits. I was intrigued when I saw those. I was searching for 1/8-inch drill bits anyway because I broke my last one. And they seem to be ones that I use fairly commonly for screw holes. They're obviously good for M3 screws. And I think number 6 and number 8 Imperial screws fit through that. These are relatively sharp. Yeah, they cut that fairly quickly. Oh, that's the other place where I use 1/8-inch drill bits to go through the tracks on this Vero board, or strip board generically, because it's not actually a Vero board branded board. So now I have 10 of these, and they're double-ended, so I can dull one end, and essentially I have 20 drill bits now. Nice. 10 pieces, 1/8-inch, 3.2 millimeter diameter HSS high-speed steel, double-ended stub metal bits, end drill stell. I don't know what that is. 2NT N4T6. I don't know what all that is. Anyways, I bought these from Glad Little Star 68, who doesn't exist on eBay anymore. If I click on his name, it just takes me nowhere. I paid $1.39 US or $1.82 Canadian back in April when I bought them. And since the seller has disappeared, I will link you to this search. As usual, dig through and sort by cheapest. Might as well, why not? But here is a random seller. Not much to say about them. Approximate length 50 millimeters, diameter 3.2 to 5.2 millimeters. I guess that depends on the size you get. High-speed steel is not suitable for use on stainless steel. Other than that, it's 10 double-ended drill bits. Next in, doesn't have any description on the customs label because it doesn't have a customs label because it came from within Canada. This is an HDMI adapter cable. Mini HDMI to standard HDMI. 3-foot length, 0.9 meters. So that is the mini HDMI and that is the standard one. Okay. Well, I ordered this to go with something else that I ordered that will be showing up eventually. But in the meantime, let's go and check the listing on this. There's nothing really special about it. It's just an HDMI cable. 3-foot HDMI to mini HDMI Type-C video converter adapter cable for TV, HDTV, DV, 1080p. Not quite sure why it says 1080p because that doesn't matter to the cable. It's just a cable. Anyway, this came from Yellow Price, who is located in Markham, Ontario, Canada. They are currently selling it for $6.99 with free shipping. Back in June when I bought it, I paid $4.88 with free shipping. And again, these prices vary all over the place. Search and find the best price for you. There's nothing particular
particular about this. It is just a standard HDMI A to HDMI C 19-pin cable. It supports all the things that HDMI supports. It is 3 feet long or just shy of a meter. And it's just an HDMI cable. Most of this is just standard HDMI stuff. I guess it's just keyword padding as usual. All these sellers do it. I should just stop ranting about it, I guess. And the last thing, also from a Canadian shipper, or Canadian seller, so therefore it doesn't have a customs invoice or anything on it to give me a clue. Although, oh, that gives me a bit of a clue. Place your bets, place your guesses in 3, 2, 1. Uh-oh, invoice. Let's hide that out of the way. It's a little box inside a big box. Has anybody guessed it yet? There's your clue. It is a Raspberry Pi 0W. Now, I've got... There is another Raspberry Pi in the house. It belongs to my son. So I'm not going to swipe it for my experiments here. I'm just going to get my own inexpensive Raspberry Pi to play with. And this is, in fact... what this is for. Doink, there it is. So I can connect that up to my television just to program it or whatever. I've got a bunch of different potential uses for this thing. Possible web server, possibly just as a Kodi box on the TV. Maybe a general purpose little computer, maybe a pie hole, maybe a pirate box. Many, many different possible uses. I might actually end up having to buy a few more of these. And of course, there's the GPIO to play with as well. I do have the Pi Cobbler, Pi T Cobbler thing that goes with my son's here, and basically that just lets you take a ribbon cable from there to here and breadboardize it. But I don't is that a different shape than the older pies, the full size pies? I'm not sure. I haven't really played with the GPIO stuff on them much. Anyway, so let's go check the listing for this guy. I didn't buy it off eBay. I bought it directly from this seller. The Raspberry Pi Zero Wireless WH with pre-soldered header. Cost me $20.94 Canadian. Plus tax, plus shipping. And back in June when I bought this, that was the absolutely best price I could find for a Raspberry Pi Zero that would ship to my part of Canada. I know they're cheaper in the States, but international shipping just kills it. So the Raspberry Pi, for those who aren't familiar with it, is a fully functional, tiny little computer with some GPIO broken out. The operating system goes onto a micro SD card. You plug it into a fairly high current USB power supply. Hook it up to a USB keyboard and mouse. Plug it into any HDMI video monitor, and you have a full computer running usually Linux, but there are other operating systems that you can throw onto the thing as well. It has 40 GPIO pins. It's only, 6.5 centimeters by 3 centimeters by 0.5 centimeter. 512 meg of RAM. And Broadcom chipset overclocked to 1 gigahertz. And some of my first 2 or 3 computers were less powerful than this. Actually, my first 2 or 3 computers combined were probably less powerful than this. It has USB on the go. It has USB for power. It has a camera port on it. Or you could use a USB camera. It has Bluetooth and Wi-Fi built into it. So it is just a handy little hacker device. You can use it for anything that you could possibly think of using a small, cheap computer for. There is a cheaper version of the Raspberry Pi Zero, 724 Canadian. It doesn't have Wi-Fi on it. It doesn't come with the header pins, but it can be used for a bunch of things too. You notice it's still got the camera interface on the side of it, USB for power and peripherals, HDMI on it. So there's still a lot you can do with that if you don't need Wi-Fi or Ethernet. And there is the results of today's Mailbag Monday opening. I'd call that a bit of a haul. Let's just quickly go through the transit times. Start with the HDMI cable. That took 11 days. It came from within Canada, so that's not a big surprise. The bag of 100 red LEDs took 47 days. The drill bits took 70 days. This 45-in-1 starter kit here took 39 days. And the Raspberry Pi took 6 days to get here from Ontario. Nice times. Obviously, ordering from within the country takes a heck of a lot less time. Anyways, I hope you enjoyed that. Found it entertaining, amusing, interesting, informative. Gave you an idea for something that you really have to order. If you're going to order stuff from eBay, I've got an affiliate link way down in the very bottom of the description. It's up to you, no pressure. Thank you, as always, to my Patreon supporters for helping me pay for this stuff, keep the mailbags rolling in, and buying me a beer now and again. And as always, thanks to you, my wonderful viewers, for stopping by every week and seeing what the hell I'm doing. Thanks. Cheers.